Michael Yaszemski has a strong passion for teamwork. He recognizes the value and necessity to have a strong team, and he's a strong believer in diversity on his team with a wide collection of diverse individuals to help achieve the goals.
He's a remarkable surgeon, a dedicated surgeon, never says no when you need his help, and does fabulous work technically. Great judgment about who should be operated and how, and with other teams coming together. He's a servant leader. He serves, and because he serves well, he's a leader.
My great uncle Michael, for whom I was named, was in Patton's Third Army and was killed coming ashore in France. I was the first boy born after that, and they gave me his name. Leadership, from my perspective, starts with followership. When we're leaders for some things. They're time limited, we do them for a while, and then we go away from them. The rest of the time, we have to be good followers, and it's that experience as a follower that really guides what to do when one is in a leadership position, from my perspective.
Mike is a driven man. He's a man who has strong beliefs about the value of both hard work as well as the value of achievement. He's also a man who is unfailingly kind and polite to everybody around him, and that helps him get everybody working together.
Perhaps Mike's greatest contribution is as a mentor, because if you think about the impact of his career, of his ideas, of his contributions, they will live through those that he has trained.
I believe in people, and given the right situation, if you will, the right leadership and a team to be a part of, most people are proud to excel and do a good job.
What you see is what you get. He's a transparent leader, and he finds a way to work through the problems. Mike was very ill at one point in time and nearly died. He was administered the last rites in the ICU at Mayo for a bleed in his head, and he recovered. He has just about completely recovered. His energy level dropped off a little bit, but Mike is nearly unflappable now. And his story about this is that once you've had the last rites administered to you, any other problem you encounter doesn't seem so bad, and so he just has this wonderful sense of perspective.
The driver is the people that I encounter and work with in a variety of ways, be they family, friends, patients, colleagues, folks who are either wanting to help others, folks who themselves are in need, and being part of a team that can offer some help to them from a medical perspective, I think is the thing that makes me want to keep doing it.